I'm the Assistant Director for Health Informatics here at the Center for Spatial Data Science. And basically this summer we've launched the Health Informatics Lab. So the Hi Lab, like hello. and because we've had so many students come over this summer, so this you guys are coming through the Dean's office. We also have interns, research interns from the Computation Institute Fellowship Program. All of you are doing so many interesting things and have so many unique approaches. It just seemed time to have a bagel hour. So do you guys want to talk about the specifics of what we do? And yeah, it's freshly launched.
Yeah, so it's just getting together for an hour or so on Fridays just to meet and talk about a paper that one of the members has highlighted for the past week. And it can be pretty much anything, usually with some relationship to what we're working on, but it's a really broad field, so just anything that they find interesting, and then we'll just discuss that paper. I do like that there is sort of a bit of, I don't want to say loneliness, but like ability to do your own thing in this, because like Tiye was saying, a lot of this can be done on your own laptop, so I've found it to be really flexible. I'm taking a couple classes this summer, and so it's not like I need to be in a specific lab from 9 to 5. I can do this whenever I have a few hours and whenever fits into my schedule, which I've really appreciated. And then we have structured time to come together and actually mingle with the other people involved. So I think there's a good balance there.
My hours are usually between 9 and 2 a.m., 9 p.m. to 2 a.m. I like the flexibility too.
And so because our lab is very much driven by work and kind of, and so my job is to not just have people like, I don't know, close envelopes for me. I don't know if that's still a job. Maybe if you work in a survey type field. But actually, I think that all the research interns, they have their own passions and interests, and we generally do better together. Like all of us have interesting experiences and I don't know, thoughts to come to the table. And I think especially because you guys are coming from different parts of University of Chicago. So we've got public policy. Arpan as kind of a CS engineer. You're coming from environmental science and this urban planning approach. I think all of you, it's not just you that you're also coming with all the wisdom and interests that you've learned from classes from these different pieces. So I think that kind of interdisciplinary approach just creates better research and it's just more interesting. Last Friday at the Bagel Hour, Helena is a student right now. She was looking at how access to dental care impacts oral cancer. And it was so interesting. So because the topic that she brought up, everyone, even though none of the rest of the interns or research assistants are looking at that specific topic, everyone had really interesting insights to bring. So some of the questions that you had that we talked about of how small sample size impacts outcomes and that sort of thing. So I think a lot of the existing literature right now struggles from being, or a lot of these research disciplines are already so isolated. What our lab does in a research level is integrate these different fields like urban planning, public health, and economic impact analysis in Tiye's case. And here we in Sam's research, a lot of, you know, built environment, traditional epidemiology, and other things. So because we're trying to do that at the research level, we have to walk that walk as well and make sure that our lab is kind of representing that same I don't know, different perspectives of looking at things. One project that we're working on is looking at the whole country, like all 73,000 tracts just in the continental U.S., looking at 15 variables across all of that, from food access to poverty to tracts that might have higher proportions of senior citizens. So we grab all this information, put it through traditional statistical analysis, and then additional spatial statistical analysis. And from this, we get these 7 neighborhood types across the whole country that are different aspects of health. So what Tiye is working on is kind of 2 aspects of that. One is because we know health is impacted by so many different components, and we want to kind of encourage different parts of the community to improve health. One part is making a business case for healthy neighborhoods and looking at the social determinants of health and crunching the numbers in a way where you can actually quantify how a potential new community development would help a neighborhood. So you've been reading a lot of different literature that covers things like the health impact analysis and other things.
Yes.
Yeah. What are some of your favorites so far?
I'm reading about some of the different ways that people are already measuring the relationship between health and environment, like the health impact assessment or the environmental impact assessment, social return on investment also. I picked out an article about why humans need to experience nature in order to maintain their health, including mental health. So, and most of our interactions with nature are just through parks because we live in increasingly urban environments. So, one thing that we might look at with our project would be the return on investment for, like, creating more parks.
And so this is a fun part of quantifying. So we kind of hypothesize that if, you know, from existing literature, if we know that there are certain relationships from the urban planning literature or health impact assessment literature, how can we bring those numbers in an easy to understand way for community developers and other types of investors to be able to look at other aspects of return? So the initial research definitely shows that you get your money back and then some. And it's something that the public health community has known for a long time and a lot of other groups. But so this has been an interesting part. And then the next part is Tiye's working on, so from this research project, we're also developing a massive social determinant of health atlas. That's an interactive web tool to explore different parts of the country. So for example, we found that areas that had similar neighborhood health typologies included Flint, Michigan, the southwest and the south and west sides of Chicago, parts of Detroit, and even parts of rural Alabama that the UN highlighted as having extreme concentrated poverty, but also parasitic outbreaks and poor health outcomes. I'm obviously very interested in kind of how health can be understood through place in these bigger contexts. So I kind of see in my future more research articles to look at that. So we work with a couple different groups. So this national group that works on infectious disease research. We also work with American Hospital Association and their nonprofit wing. There's a lot of work that we've done with our colleagues at the Chicago Department of Public Health. One of our new health projects looking at air quality is officially connected to different researchers at NASA. So it's kind of an exciting place to be in.